Welcome to the GoGTS Live Christmas Spectacular with your hosts, Ivan Lundgren and Rob Bertrand.
Welcome to the GoGTS Live Christmas Spectacular. I'm your host, Rob Bertrand. Joining me as always, Ivan Lovgren. Merry Christmas and happy holidays, everybody. Ivan, how are you, buddy?
I'm doing absolutely fantastic, Rob. I have a plethora of drinks with me tonight because it is Christmas. So we got to celebrate, most notably, Brugiere's, the absolute greatest eggnog on the planet. Look at this. It's like liquid gold in my hands. Rob, we're giving away everything on the show tonight except for this Brugiere's. This is staying here with me. It's not going anywhere.
Fair enough. I'm glad to see you brought the festiveness with you. That's awesome. Is there any rum in there or anything, or is it just virgin nog?
Well, I mean, what kind of host would I be if I did the show with alcohol? So there, for your own viewing pleasure.
Nice.
It's crazy enough doing this show sober, Rob. I couldn't even imagine. Mixing and mingling. And trying to get up with what you haven't even mentioned yet, which is tonight's show is ridiculous.
It is ridiculous.
We have 20, 22, 24, 27, 12 days of Christmas, 12 ways to enter to win. That's a completely different thing. We're giving away so much, Rob. I don't even know what's going on anymore. All I know is it's the holidays, and I'm excited for Christmas. So explain to me what is happening tonight.
Well, first of all, Ivan, an apology. I know. Last week I said we'd be giving away a box every 12 minutes.
Did you lie to the audience, Rob?
I did.
The fanboys are not going to be happy about that.
Because I counted the boxes and then did some math. And if we stuck to the... Because last year we had the 12 days of Christmas and gave away 12 boxes every day leading up to Christmas. So
yeah,
we wanted to do...
Great.
We had so many, we thought we'd do the 12 minutes of Christmas.
Yeah, I like that a lot better.
But... We have 22 boxes to give away, 12 minutes. If we waited 12 minutes, we would be here for nearly a five-hour show.
I'm game.
So we had to cut that in half, and now...
Rob, I got all of this Brugiere's to get through.
Once we start that timer that you see, we'll be giving a box away every 6 minutes. And before we start that timer, let me give you guys a little rundown of what's going on. We have several box breaks in addition to a lot of gifting going on tonight. We have that in, four different box break segments for a total of 12 boxes. And we have...
Am I the only one that just lost, Rob?
So much stuff going on.
Is it just me, or are people in the audience not able to hear Rob? Rob, I apologize if they can hear you and I'm talking over you. This is internal technical difficulties, or this eggnog really does have something in it, and it is kicking in already. That said, Rob, while you're going through all that we're giving away, I also wanted to mention, you reminded me with the 12 ways of Christmas, there's 12 ways to enter that giveaway. So if you're watching on Facebook or on live stream, you just got a link in your chat from me, disguised as GoGTS Live in some cases, with how you can enter to win that. So don't forget to enter to win that. Rob, can we hear you? Are you talking right now?
Can you hear me?
You sound like Timmy Cricket. What's his name? Tiny Jiminy.
James got kicked off the call and then called in, and then when I answered it, it put my call on hold.
Ah, well, that's the fault. Well, if you don't mind helping me out here, and then that way we can maybe balance the levels just to check real quick. I'm also want to fill them in on all the other things they can win before we start this clock. So again, the 12 ways of Christmas prize pack. Also, Rob,
please go through for new viewers. I know
yes.
We have a lot of new viewers tonight. Go through all that.
Yes. So new viewers. So we only have so many ways that we can figure out everything that's going on. So what I need you to do is, first and foremost, go to Twitter right now. Go to GoGTS Live on Twitter, twitter.com/GoGTS Live, and you have enough time this show to start an account.
Yes. Yes, you do.
Oh, and hey, Rob, you're back. So we'll jump right into this. But there is a tweet that is up there that is pinned. Pinned tweet. It says, this is the pinned tweet for tonight's show. I don't want to criticize anybody too much. Come on, people, though. Some of the questions we get, what time do you go on? It's right there on the banner. If you love us and if you want to win something, do just a little extra work and read some stuff. That said, we spelled it out for you. This is the pinned tweet for tonight's show. Well, you have to retweet that tweet because that's the only way that we can track everybody across Facebook, Twitch, YouTube, Facebook live stream, Periscope. I am so sorry, Periscope. There is a bandwidth issue, and we just cannot monitor Periscope because tonight you do have to be live to win. You are going to draft your box from the list that's on Twitter when you win. So we're going to go through all the boxes that we're giving away, and it's going to narrow down what's available. That said, you have to reply in chat to win, and sadly, we just can't monitor Periscope because the chat things show up and then disappear. So if you're watching on Periscope, make sure that you're also watching somewhere else. Or shoot us a nice tweet message, and we'll think about you.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So that's going to be how you enter to win those. Is that also going to count for the box breaks, the previews? Because we've got so many product previews going on.
Exactly. We're going to keep it simple.
Okay. But let's still tweet out if we get some fun stuff and we can actually tag the athletes or the stars or celebrities. Let's still tweet out those hits for fun. That being said, if you're brand new to the show also, this is GoGTS Live, the Hobbies web show. There's lots of great podcasts out there. We're actually combining shows with one of them next week, the Fat Packs of Beckett Radio. But this is really a hobby news show sponsored by GTS Distribution. So it's agnostic when it comes to which products matter, product information. We've even broken retail products on here that they don't carry. I say all that to set you up for GoGTS.net. So the show is GoGTS Live. The website is GoGTS.net, and it is a media warehouse for card collecting. Segments on particular products, product breakdowns, checklists, previews, release dates, as well as my favorite segment, Future Watch. So if you buy some of these newer products and you see all these rookies or prospects that you don't know who they are, check out Future Watch. So keep that in mind as we're going through.
Absolutely.
That's who's doing all this. Thank the product manufacturers for supporting us in all of this. That's our mission. There is one more thing I need to do before we can set off that timer, Rob, and that's let them know about next week. You need to go vote. They've got, 12 more hours to vote, Rob?
Tomorrow until 11:59 p.m. Eastern time.
Okay, excellent. James, is there any way I couldn't find the link. Can you just smack me with that link in the chat, and I will share that to the chat rooms? So the link to vote, because we're also giving away more boxes if you vote. So we're 10 votes shy of 1,000 right now, Rob? Is that it? 17 votes shy of 1,000 votes?
So, I don't think we're that close, but that's what we want to get to.
So we got to push it. So let's do that. And that's all I got to say. If you were unclear about any of that, well, you'll get it as we go along. It's like playing Risk. You may lose the first round, but we're here all night. We got plenty of rounds of Risk to play.
All right. And just so you know, when you guys hear the following sound, this is when you know it's time to give away a box. Yeah, exactly.
That'll wake you up.
All right. So let's kick off. Let's kick off things with our regularly scheduled segment, a little bit of I don't know why. I'll try to check that out. let's try that one more time. Oh, you know what? It was user error. We're juggling a lot of stuff.
Was I the only one that woke up from that?
Here's the sound that you're gonna wanna be paying attention to. You won't be able to miss it, I swear.
I know him.
Yeah, that's the one. That's the one. Okay.
There you go.
So the timer is officially started. Let's dive into our first topic. This is when we take a look at what we like to call hobby happenings. All right. A lot going on this week.
Tons.
Good to go, Joe?
Turn that sound off. Yep.
All right. Well, if the recent run on Shohei Ohtani's Topps Now card is any indication of what collector demand will be like for 2018 Topps MLB baseball cards, retailers have a lot to look forward to. The Japanese superstar's first Topps Now card broke the program's print run record with 17,323 copies sold in just a 24-hour period.
Wow.
The previous Topps Now record was the card of Aaron Judge, which featured his record-breaking 50th home run, which sold 16,138 copies. So the young Japanese prospect absolutely shattered the record.
Rob, also this week in celebration of the holidays, our friend and collector, Susan LaJudai, who is the marketing communications manager at Topps, shared this photo on her Twitter feed. Now, it's well known that all Topps employees get gifts each year. Well, this year they were gifted with one of the pictured cards, each of which appears to have a print run of just 20 copies. This is the third consecutive year Topps employees have received such an early Christmas gift. In 2015, four different Chris Bryant cards featuring the 1990 Topps design were created, with each being numbered to 25. Paying homage to the Frank Thomas No Name on Front error card that is notorious, one of the versions of Bryant's card intentionally replicated the error. Last year, the company distributed one of four different cards of Ichiro Suzuki, again, each with a print run of 25. A very cool gesture on the part of Topps, and happy holidays to our friend Suze.
Very cool. And in autograph news, a recent thread on the popular forum Freedom Cardboard is creating a bit of a stir. Now, I'm no autograph authenticator or handwriting expert, but I'm in agreement with the person that posted these comparison photos of Royce Clayton's Bowman Chrome autographs, which definitely appear to have been signed by different people. I know signatures can vary. Mine does. But typically what never varies, at least to too much of a degree anyway, is the first letters of my first and last name. Here you can clearly see the pretty drastic differences in the R and the L on each of the cards. We'll monitor the situation and provide any updates to this developing story.
Meanwhile, in auction news, a handwritten letter by Babe Ruth has smashed the previous record for a correspondence penned by the Sultan of Swat, showing that when it comes to the value of handwritten letters, content is king. This particular letter was written by Ruth to Harry Neely, a well-known and esteemed Chicago sports writer and an MVP voter. The letter personally thanks Neely for the vote he cast for Ruth as league MVP in 1923. Remarkably, it was the only MVP award of Ruth's Hall of Fame career, which he kind of looks pretty tickled about in this photo. The letter is sat in a box in a closet of Neely's grandniece, who inherited it in the 1960s. The letter was recently sold at auction by Mile High Card Company for $88,780.
Wow. You know, the story of well-known online retailer and Buffalo, New York area stores, Dave and Adams Card World, is a classic one. Two lifelong friends, each passionate collectors in their own right, shared a common vision to start their own e-commerce business when the internet was still in its infancy. The two sold their collections for needed capital, and the rest is really history. So it was nice to see a piece of Buffalo sports history end up in the right hands, theirs. Dave and Adams Card World recently purchased a slice of NHL history thanks to Heritage Auctions' November catalog. The company was the winning bidder for the original 1970 document, awarding a National Hockey League franchise to the city. Dated May 15, 1970, the one-page certificate granted the then Niagara Frontier Hockey Corporation an expansion team for the 1970-71 season. That team became the Buffalo Sabres. An article this week on Sports Collectors Daily quoted Adam Martin, CEO and co-owner, saying, "This is truly a one-of-a-kind collectible. and is one of the most important pieces in all of Buffalo sports history. When we saw this come up for auction, we felt an obligation to win it. We just couldn't let this slip away and end up anywhere other than Western New York. Once framed, the certificate will go on display at the company's Williamsville, New York store location. Nice job, guys. Congratulations. That's very, very, very cool.
I absolutely love the fact that they're keeping it as well.
You know what that sound means.
Oh boy.
Right, little hobby happenings. It's time to give away our first box.
Can we do that? Can we interrupt hobby happenings?
Every 6 minutes.
Okay.
Baby.
Okay.
All right.
All right. Well, what did you understand about that?
It wasn't clear.
You didn't make it clear in the tweet.
Every 6 minutes.
What time does the show start?
I'm running into an issue too. I can pick the random retweeter right now, and I have it. But my Facebook is also crashing. Is anyone else having that problem?
We broke Facebook.
Yeah, it's not showing me chat on the live video. So hopefully people are here.
There's 94 people.
But it's not showing me the chat. 96, 100. What's going on?
So the winner is Easy E Sports Cards, Easy E 1014 Sports Cards, who I'm pretty sure is a Facebook viewer. And I can't see the chat right now. And I'm guessing that they must be in there because of the...
Well, we just go with it right now on Facebook. Roll with it, bro.
So do me a favor. Tweet us or DM us on Twitter or just shoot us a tweet, EZE1014, because we're monitoring Twitter also. And let us know. You get the first pick of the boxes. So the list is on the penned tweet on the site. So tweet us and let us know. And I apologize if anybody else wants to check, too, and see if their chat's working. Like, mine's just a big white box. I don't know what's going on. I feel like we got to wrap it up before we get. We're gonna have to give away another box though before we even go on. So, that being said, should we step back into hobby happenings?
Absolutely.
All right. So, congratulations to Dave and Adam's Card World on that amazing pickup and piece of history. Rob, there's also big happenings in collectibles business news this past week. eBay announced that it has acquired longtime API licensee Terapeak, which is a Toronto-based company that uses supply, demand, and pricing data to help sellers make decisions on what to sell, when to sell it, and at what price. eBay will begin integrating certain functionality from Terapeak into its seller hub upon close of the deal, which is supposed to come before the end of the year. Ownership by eBay will mean sellers will have access to more tools through the seller hub. The detailed data offered by Terapeak includes historical sales that go back much further than the 90 days eBay users currently have access to. Terapeak operated on a paid subscription model, and it will be interesting to see if eBay tries to recoup the purchase costs with increased store subscription fees.
Oh, I'm sure you can probably count on it. Chances are, if you're breathing, that you've seen at least once the timeless and classic movie, A Christmas Story. But did you know that besides being a fan of cowboy westerns, Little Ralphie was also a baseball card collector? One astute observer on Twitter, at Beauty of a Game, posted this picture saying, "Like many of us, I've seen A Christmas Story 372 times, but it wasn't until last year that I noticed Ralphie's vintage baseball cards on his headboard." And of course, leave it to the collecting community on Twitter to within minutes identify the exact cards. A 1940 Playball John Rucker of the New York National League, a T206 Ed Ruhlbach, Chicago National League, and a T206 at Jimmy Hart Montgomery, the Alabama Southern League. Man, you gotta love Twitter.
And finally, Rob, in the current era of the No Fun League, that's NFL, if you are lagging behind, could the XFL, the Extra Fun League, be making a comeback? Well, it appears so. ESPN's Darren Rovell, always a trusted source, reported on Twitter today that Vince McMahon's Alpha Entertainment has filed for 5 trademarks to XFL. However, the real question that needs to be asked, since this is GoGTS Live, is, will we see a subsequent return of Topps XFL football cards as well?
Do you remember those?
That would be a Merry Christmas for me.
That's funny. Well, and that's a look at this week's hobby happenings. Some interesting stuff. First off, how many times have you seen A Christmas Story?
At least 20.
Right.
And I know people say hundreds, but let's be realistic here. At least 20. That's a lot. That's a lot of times.
You know, I'm pretty in tune to things like that, like seeing baseball cards. Like I found them in the wall of George Costanza's office at Yankee Stadium. In a few episodes on Seinfeld, Jerry had a box of Don Ross baseball cards on top of the refrigerator. And I've seen that movie hundreds of times. I never noticed that before either. So that's really pretty cool.
That is very awesome.
And I really love the fact that Twitter, it was almost instantaneous that somebody jumped on that and was able to figure out what those cards were. And I know, man, Suze is absolutely doing backflips over her Christmas present. She's a huge, huge Derek Jeter collector. And so that is right up her alley.
So, Rob, I apologize. I'm hitting technical difficulties. My Facebook is not loading the video at all. I don't know what's going on. I don't know if it's bandwidth here at home, making sure the Wi-Fi.
Wi-Fi is off on myself. But
maybe James, our associate producer.
You know what that sound is? It's time to give away another box.
Right when I'm having technical difficulties. Right when I'm having technical difficulties. Well, it sounds like, first off, I'm hearing from the asset that EZE did claim his box of Elite Extra Edition, Panini Elite Extra Edition. So, Rob, do you want to grab that, show it to the camera, take it off the shelf? And
I'm not going to be able to do that without endangering a massive disaster.
Oh, I know. That's why I wanted
back
you to
there.
Do it. Jenga. All right. So we got to write this down. Elite Extra Edition. I got to write it down over here. Extra Edition. Well, Brett Howie, if you're watching, you're our second winner. So congratulations. And
nice.
Again, James, are you able to check in on the Facebook? And I can maybe load YouTube. Brett Howie. So if we can find you, if you're on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, wherever, let us know which of the remaining boxes Panini Elite Extra Edition is off.
Brett
Howard? The Twitter name is Brett Howie. That's all I know. Okay. Oh, watching on YouTube, it sounds like. So, yeah. So let us know which box you would like us to take off, and we shall do so.
Nice.
All right.
Good job, guys. Way to handle on the fly.
Yeah, thank you. I'm literally watching the spinning thing on Facebook. I'm like, what's going on? And it's crazy because the few times I get in there, the numbers are astronomical, and I'm not able to chat with all of you. I feel so bad. That said, go to GoGTS.net.
All right. Well, we're going to dive into our first segment of box breaks. We've got a 3-box break of Panini NBA products. Like I said, we have 4 segments tonight. This is the first one, and we're going to kick things off with a little 2017-18 Panini Court Kings basketball. Always been a fan of this brand.
It's extra fun tonight, Rob, because it is one pack with 10 cards, so it should be a quick break. That said, again, the way that you enter to win the hits that we decide to give away for this is by retweeting the pinned tweet at GoGTS Live. Letting your friends know. Share on Facebook. Click that little share button. Give us some emojis. If you're on Twitch, I don't know how you share it, but do something. Twitch or something. This box is going to include 1 autographed card, 1 memorabilia card, 1 insert card, and 2 rookies, plus, Rob, 1 oversized 5x10, 5x7 box topper in every box. And as you probably know, these are the most artistic cards in the world.
I'm glad you said that because I was literally getting ready to throw the box away because that thing is in there.
Awesome.
It wasn't visible. It was glued to the top.
It was a box. It was literally the box top was a card.
Should we save that for last or do it now?
Save it for last. I have a little suspense.
Okay.
I have a little fun.
All right.
I have a little faith in me.
Do you guys remember when Topps and Allen and Ginter put cards in the top of the box itself? and a bunch of people. I mean, it was stealth. It wasn't advertised in the sell sheet or anything. And tons of people threw their boxes away without realizing it.
Yeah, it was like 2 days later that somebody finally said, oh, hey, by the way, I randomly ripped open my box and there was a card in there. And then
Renaissance Man.
Breakers that had been doing a whole bunch were.
There's like, a rookie of Lonzo Ball.
Ooh, hey.
Prestige insert of Kevin
Greatest
Durant.
Greatest Laker of all time.
Memorabilia card, Sacramento Kings center, Willie Cauley-Stein. Kyrie Irving.
All right.
Dennis Schroeder. Right. And our auto, boom, nice. Dennis Smith Jr. of the Mavericks on card.
Ooh, look at that. On card, fresh paint autograph of Dennis Smith Jr. of the Mavericks.
Beautiful. All right.
Very Kings. Cool. There's also four rookie card variations. Do you mind showing the Lonzo Ball one more time real quick?
Not a problem. I can do that. No, that's okay. And just so you know, if this memorabilia card would have been more of a boom to our new viewers, we'd give this one away live on air. Instead, we'll put this into one of our monthly prize packs.
Which you can also enter to win through one of our many tweets.
All righty. Lonzo Ball.
Actually, so that is a, I think, according to this thing, it's a level 2 variant of Lonzo Ball.
Oh. It says it right on the back with Roman numerals up.
So there. I did all
that.
This investigative sleuthing. And for once, it's clear to see on a Panini card. Well, hey, also, I've got some quick news. You know, Rob, something that we deal with on the show often is collectors complaining about this and logos that and this and that. Well, guess what the first two boxes were to go? They were two Panini baseball boxes without logos. Brett picked Panini Chronicles. So, I don't know. You guys like to complain, but I don't know. There are short
got
print
the box topper
autographs, Rob, that feature on-card signatures of stars and legends.
You know what that sound means. Hold on. We're going to have to wait on that box topper.
Oh.
Time to give away another box.
All right. Well, let's do it super quick. I don't have time. I don't have time for any of this. Ryan Channels. Ryan, if you are watching, Ryan Channels, shoot us a message. Tell us what box you want from the remaining boxes.
Stephen Curry, not an auto, but a really nice. See, ooh. I like the horizontal format of that. That is beautiful.
I agree. Horizontal box toppers are.
Let's give this away. This is sweet.
Panoramic. Okay, so we got the Curry.
Get a picture of that, James. We'll give this away. Yeah, I know.
So Curry box topper, and what was the Smith auto? Smith
Dennis
Jr.
Smith Jr.
Yeah, just throw it out there for fun with a link. I'll click on the link and see if it actually works for me. My flailing. All right, so.
So who is the winner of the other box?
I told you, Ryan Channels.
Ryan Channels.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, that was for that. Zoso56. Congratulations, Ryan. Thank you for tuning in. And I have no clue if he's watching on live stream. Where he's watching. I guess, is it easier to just have people tweet at, like, send us a tweet?
Or a DM.
Yeah, a DM.
Yeah, send us a DM.
Yeah, send us a DM with your actual prize thing. But you got to do it, like, right away. If we don't get it by the next 6 minutes, we'll give it away to someone else. If he's watching on live stream, he might be late because I'm watching that and we're at 40 seconds still. Live stream delay.
Four minutes and 6 seconds and counting until the next one.
Gosh,
all right. Totally certified basketball. We have eight packs per box, five cards per pack, one autograph, one memorabilia card per box on average.
All right. Awesome. Also, Ryan Channels, he switched it up. He went non-sports. Grab the Gotham box. Did not see that one coming. Did you see that one coming, Rob? Especially because Ryan's a huge basketball fan, a huge Steph Curry fan. But he went after Gotham.
Good for him.
Lots of fun.
I emptied my trash can today. I'm glad I did. Certainly going to need all the space we can get with 12 breaks.
Yeah, because, again, not only are we giving away all that crap, that's what I called it. Yeah, you heard me. We also are opening 12 different boxes as product previews. So don't forget to tweet the manufacturers. Thank them for supplying all of this stuff for us to preview for you, the audience, and the collectors.
Certified mail insert. Very cool.
Yeah, except that it's Rudy Gobert. Isn't that the worst when you get a cool insert of a guy that's just like, come on.
I know.
Come on.
It's going to happen, though.
Yeah, I know. You have to. It's really the nature of the beast.
You know what I hate, though?
I didn't get value in this box. Well, of course.
I hate when people refer to any professional athlete as a scrub. It's like, dude, they represent like the 1% of 1%. Hey, here's the Lakers' best rookie right now.
Lonzo Ball?
No. Kyle Kwama.
Yeah.
Number to 299.
He's no Lonzo.
Kuzma, my bad. Kyle Lowry. And
ooh, I'm getting DMs.
Kyrie Middleton.
I'm getting hate DMs from Cardinals fans. This is fun. Completely unprompted. I love it. I'm gonna see if I can get
John
back
Collins. Kind of a graffiti motif going on back there with the foil board. That's pretty cool. Chandler Parsons and Kyrie.
Oh,
this pack feels a little
bit
thicker.
Oh no, that's from a month ago. I got a Facebook video with a chat, and then I realized it was the Facebook video from a month ago.
And our first hit is a Fabric of the Game of Malik Monk, an oversized swatch there.
That is oversized.
We'll definitely give away this one. Yeah.
And I'm back in Facebook, so hi, Facebook people. I can read you now.
You got it? Okay.
Yeah, and I guess I should say, because it's been so long, don't forget, in order to enter to win the box break hit giveaways and the box giveaways, unopened box giveaways, you have to go to twitter.com/GoGTSLive and retweet our pinned tweet. It also helps everybody if you go on, if you're watching on Facebook, if you click that little share button or give us some emojis.
Kevin Durant, the mighty.
Little emojis. Let us know your feelings. How do you feel about that? How do you feel about Tim Hardaway Jr.?
Malcolm Brogdon. Yeah, and if you like free box breaks, we do this every week on GoGTS Live.
Yeah. Free box breaks, interviews. Rob, am I correct that we may have a superstar on the show come January?
We are efforting one Don Mattingly. How cool would that be?
That'd be pretty cool. I'd actually
have to up my interview game.
Uh-oh, wait a second.
Might have to bring on Manus for that.
Got to set those down. It is an auto, but that sound means we have to give away another box.
Oh, all right. The nice thing is I'm doing this through tweet draw, so I'm just keeping the tweet in there. And April Bendixson, April, I hope that you're watching. You've got 6 minutes to DM us the box that you want from the boxes remaining. Again, so far, Elite Extra Edition, Panini Chronicles, and Gotham have all been chosen. I know that your husband also watches the show. Will it be a box for him, or will it be a box for you? Also, all of our winners. Look, we're doing a lot of work tonight. We need you to raise the bar just a little bit and do a little bit of it yourself. You have to email us your mailing information, because we can't get these to you otherwise. So make sure the email address is twitter.com. It's GoGTSLive, the name of the show, at GoGTS.net, the name of the website I was telling you about. Remember that website, GoGTS.net, that has all of the news
all right.
and information you need?
Yeah, I'm going to get back to this break now. Wayne Seldon Jr.
Again.
Auto numbered to 99.
Okay, that's pretty cool. I was trying to be dismissive because it was... Memphis.
We'll go ahead and give this one away. It's a signed, sealed, and delivered.
Yeah, but he's kind of a scrub.
Oh, I hate you.
That's what you get for saying schwag.
Did you get that photo? Okay, thanks. And we've got a parallel, a shiny parallel, not numbered. I know you don't like that, Ivan, of Devin Booker.
Yeah. Number that shiz. It ain't that hard. Just get a stamp. Boom.
Nikola Jokic and Rodney Hood. And we have two packs left.
I like my parallels like I like my cattle. Branded.
Dwayne Wade. Kevin Durant. Darren Collinson, shiny unnumbered parallel. Patty Mills, Patty, nice name. And Goran Dragic. Last pack, Mojo, maybe, just maybe. Doesn't look like it. Damian Lillard.
Okay.
Aaron Borden.
Okay.
Rudy Gobert. Hey, you don't like that guy, and here he is in another one. All right, so give away the auto and the memorabilia from that box. Set these to the side. Now we have one with it's got a few more packs in it. We got Prism first. It's okay. Prism Basketball, two autographs. The current SRP on this product is unbelievable. $300 a box.
And the current prices on the hits that we've been seeing have also been absolutely unbelievable. I don't know what it is about this rookie class or if it's just this new structure of high-end Panini Prism. They knew that it was the popular one in basketball, and they built it to match. Each box has 12 packs, so Rob, you can go ahead and get ripping. Get into that. Get going. It's going to deliver two autographed cards. So we're going to get two autos in here, 22 prism cards and 10 insert cards. Follow the rainbow of your favorite players with parallels from unnumbered all the way up to one of ones. And let me tell you, when I say prices have been crazy on these rookies, it's on those parallels. Those parallels are ridiculous. They are hot. Autos are great. Parallels are actually what we're chasing in this product. A nice number to five or one of one, Markelle Fultz or Lonzo Ball. That'll set the show up. We won't need a sponsorship from Brugiers, which, by the way, Brugiers, send some your brother's way.
Tobias Harris.
Yeah.
And that is a parallel. $199.
Also, it seems like April picks Illusions. Which sport is Illusions? I know I have it somewhere, but which?
April picks Illusions. I'm writing all this down as well, so we have some redundancy.
So that was one box of Panini Illusions football. We do have a second box of Panini Illusions football, so that doesn't mean that Illusions is off. Does not mean that Illusions is off. Just jumped over to live stream. Great suggestion from Mikey Bedell. Wicked Mikey. He thinks Rob and Ivan should look up and down when talking to each other like the Brady Bunch. What do you think about that, Rob?
You want us to switch the box, the layout boxes? There's a fundamentals insert of Miles Turner.
And then where's the asset? See upper left?
Gosh, hey, I was James. Just going to say something I forgot. Get hype.
Oh, sorry.
Joel Embiid. Fundamentals, Rick Barry. Shiny, no numbering. Really shiny.
Also, Rob, is this product allocated? All their basketball stuff this year is allocated, right?
Every single basketball product.
Because I do see, we're fair here. We have Stevens Collectibles, who is a card shop owner, in the live stream chat, and he's complaining. I think maybe his complaint is valid. He ordered a case, and he got two boxes. So when some other people say, why is this so expensive? Well, it's because it's allocated. They're not producing this at grocery store levels this year. So,
Aaron Gordon.
That said, the timer is counting down.
Counting down. I'm sure everyone can see it. Put your earbuds in. Be ready.
All right. Before you pick that, we do have a kind of a wavy Eric Bledsoe. It's not a rookie, but it's pretty cool looking.
Is it numbered on the back?
No.
Ah, okay. Our winner is David Mackey. David, regular viewer of the show. You watching tonight?
Well, that's what I wanted. That's what I wanted to say. Normally during the show, if You can be a repeat winner, but we're not doing that this week.
Yeah.
We want to spread as much hobby Christmas cheer as possible, so no repeat winners this week.
Yeah, yeah. Sorry, that was in our internal notes. I didn't want to say that because, you know, David Mackey's going to turn off the show and go watch Ernest Saves Christmas now that he won. But
no, he won't.
That's just a joke.
No, he won't.
By the way, Ernest Saves Christmas, the greatest Christmas movie of all time. I know we're talking about A Christmas Story. Ernest freaking Saves Christmas is, it's hotter than J-Max farts. That's what it is. And
our first auto is of Trey Lyles.
Oh, there we go. Non-numbered, non-on-card, sticker auto, Trey Lyles. Should I write that down for a giveaway?
I'm sorry. Yeah, we could give that away.
Yeah, he's a scrub.
No, he's not. You got it? Okay. All right, Paul Gasol.
Hey, even a broken clock is right twice a day. Remember that when you call a guy not a scrub just because he's playing well.
David West, Jahlil Okafor, TJ Warren.
How about this, Rob, too, just to help out with that. I forgot to write down April, Bendix and Illusions.
Fundamentals, Jeremy Lin with his man bun.
To help out with it on both sides, how about we don't necessarily veto on the cards, on the hits? Like, you can still win a possible hit. Just because that's a lot of names for me to keep track of, too.
Oh, no, that's what I meant.
Oh, okay, just the boxes. Okay, so no one's winning two boxes. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, cool. Thank you, because that actually makes it a whole lot easier.
Yeah, on the Ivester, what I meant.
Ivan Claus over here.
We're on the same page.
Okay, cool. So, yeah, so sorry, Ryan, you do have to keep watching, because I know you want that Steph Curry box topper. And who else did we say? So April had Illusions. And did I say David Mackey already? Or did you cut me off before I said it?
No, I said you got it.
Okay. Okay.
Don't worry about it. He's good for it. Jamal Crawford. Terrence Ross.
Who's Some seen people David say,
well, why do you guys show the base cards? Do you know how many people we have had tell us one of the ways they make buying decisions on products is how the base cards look? So we want to be sure to do that.
Oh, absolutely.
We try to do it quickly because we know some of you guys are hitmongers.
I mean, to be fair, he is a regular, but Rob, we do have rules. If he's got until the 6-minute mark, if at the next bell, I click that button twice.
Fundamentals.
Just keep that in mind.
How about Greg Popovich? A shiny parallel, not numbered. That would have made it a great auto. I know he has autos in here. Jimmy Butler still in a Bulls uniform. And that is numbered to 75. I have a programming note related to Jimmy Butler at the end of the program. You guys are going to want to be sure to stay tuned to the end of the program.
Ah, there's Mackie. Mackie's going with the second Illusions. Glad you got here in time. Actually, he got on the one with the furthest delay, so that's probably why. Also, it might be in your best interest if you're watching, because the other thing is you got to go back to that Twitter list. So say, hey, I'm here. And then go look and figure out which box you want.
Tobias Fair, Harris. Right? Speaking of breaks, I actually purchased 4 spots in a break for tomorrow. Any guesses what product it is?
Transcendent.
No, it wasn't Transcendent.
Flopping down that 250 a spot.
Wow, Markieff Morris. That's what a cracked ice parallel. And that is numbered to just 99.
Ooh, very cool. Also, I see our numbers are continuing to go up. Thank you, everyone, for sharing. Don't forget to share on Facebook and leave your emojis. Let us know what cards you like. Give us little emojis for the cards you like and the cards you don't like. And share it on Facebook. If you're brand new to the program, if you're just tuning in, the way that you enter to win all the ginormous hits that we assume are why you're coming in, maybe you actually did just see us, though, and that's cool, too. We're giving away tons of boxes of cards, tons of autographed cards, tons of great cards. You have to go
Josh
to Twitter.
Jackson,
Twitter.com/GoGTSLive. That's a very cool insert card, that emergence.
Doc Rivers. Bismarck Biyombo.
I've been to Doc Rivers' house.
Oh, really? That's cool. I like him. I always have.
He was ridiculously kind, considering I was like 2 hours late with his order.
He had to take this.
Very kind. Actually, I think I can say this now because everybody's suing Postmates anyways. He tipped me like a boss, which I thought was unreal.
There's no box toppers in Prism, is there? I can throw this one away.
There are no box toppers guaranteed in every box. So David Mackey took illusions. Doc Rivers is a good guy.
We have to wait to open that pack.
Whoa. Is anyone else's head ringing?
Time to give away another box.
Sounds like somebody strangled a reindeer. Oh my god. All right, well, let's hit that random retweet button again. By the way, someone mentioned that, you have to refresh the tweet. I did do that. I have refreshed the tweet and tweet draw. Kept it simple. I listened to your complaints. I'm trying to be fair. Shut up. Stop complaining. This goes to Captain Coconut, S. Bratton 34. S. Bratton 34.
Coconut.
So, all right. S. Bratton, are you here? You may want to do yours through Twitter, shooting us a DM, because I could say I'm S. Bratton. I look like an S. Bratton, don't I? Yeah, and no complaining. Really, if I see anybody complain about anything, you're going Which into the boo Stevens? Box. The blocked box. That's what boo box
Miles
stands
Turner,
for.
Turner, Thomas Bryant, Marvin Williams. Two packs left.
We need a hook set.
So, does anybody have any guesses out there of what break I bought into?
I already told you, Transcendent, man. I believe in you. You are
not Transcendent. Let's do this. How about the first person that correctly guesses? I'll give away one of the hits we weren't going to give away. Donovan Mitchell.
Brad Jorgensen
Donovan
just got
Mitchell.
In.
Oh, gosh, that's good. That is a boom. Ooh. For sure. Donovan Mitchell. It's not a numbered parallel, but he is hot right now.
Yeah, no, that's great. You know, Prism, again, it's iconic for most basketball card rookies, I'd say. Very, very cool. Rob,
you
is it first or first that I see? Because that could also get us in trouble.
Uh-oh. First that you see.
Okay.
Donovan Mitchell.
Because also there's multiple channels going on here. Squiggle D is pretending like I ditched him. Come on, Squiggle D. I'm watching you live streamers. I see what's going on.
Are you sure Rudy Gobert? I mean, this one's numbered to 49.
Well, I don't know.
We've got lots of
move
his cards.
My hot tea and my Brugier's eggnog and
Malik Monk.
Mute this so that my keyboard doesn't make everybody annoyed.
Last pack. Yeah, Captain Coconut.
Yes, Captain Coconut.
S. Bratton. Sean Kilpatrick.
That's as long as he needs to take a second to pick his box, Johnson. That makes total sense. I get that.
Avery Bradley.
But he's watching. That's what matters.
DeMarcus Cousins, Fundamentals. Ooh, nice. Oh, I wish it was numbered. Kevin Durant. Why is that not numbered? How about Rick Carlisle?
That Rudy Gobert orange numbered to 49, $399 on eBay. Boom.
Nicolo Meritek and Chandler Parsons rounds out our box of Prism basketball.
All right.
Housekeeping.
So Donovan Mitchell. Prism auto.
Okay. Take a little break from box breaks and
Rob,
yeah,
how about $100 or even better, $125 for that Donovan Mitchell Prism.
Sweet.
Boom. Jazzy boom. Hashtag jazzy boom. I say jazzy because my card shop owner, when I was a little kid, used to say that when we pull a gold bordered Topps card of a all-star. Rob says
like
boom because he likes the noise it makes. So that's
boom.
A jazzy boom.
All right. That's good to know. Absolutely good to know.
So did we get something from S. Bratton? Did he say what it was that he wanted?
Not yet. Did
I heard it was in YouTube.
So out of those breaks, Ivan, which we got a good look at three relatively newer releases. Which one did you like the best aesthetically? Court Kings, Prism, Totally Certified.
So it's actually tough. Like we, are you going to make me say bad things?
Yeah.
Sorry, we're breaking news.
Uh-oh.
Because we got so much going on right now. Ryan Channels, first off, congratulations, Ryan Channels, for not dropping out after winning a box of cards. Ryan Channels has sent us a message saying that since we didn't go fully through the sell sheet, this is why, people, this is why. That was from Prism, right?
I don't remember seeing that card.
That was from Prism? So Prism has a case hit called Luck of the Lottery. 10 insert cards in every box. Get Hyped, Fundamentals, Emergent, Luck of the Lottery. He's saying that Luck of the Lottery is a case hit. Is that true?
I'm looking. I'm looking to see if we got it.
I don't know if we have time to do these things.
Hey, if it's a case hit, we will make time.
But that's,
most definitely.
That's what you guys are here for.
So it looks like a regular.
Uh-oh. You know what that sound means.
Oh, boy.
I'm behind.
Refresh.
Another box.
I need to reopen tweet draw and refresh the tweet to see if we've gone up. Well, yeah, we've gone up in retweets, so everybody gets a chance.
Emergent.
Tweet draw. It looks like a normal card. It's like a border on the normal card, like a silver border on the normal card.
Crap.
And
really?
What, did you find it?
No, not necessarily. It won't say Luck
no,
of the
it does.
Lottery
it does.
It.
But I'm just saying, like, it doesn't, okay, like, have a different design.
Oh, there it is. Okay, yeah, you're right.
Hey, did we find
did
it?
Get a case hit. It's not numbered. It is the 8th overall pick for the New York Knicks, Frank Ntilikina.
Oh, very
and
cool.
And we did a Future Watch player profile on him this week.
Yeah.
So let's give this away. And thank you, Ryan, for pointing that out.
Rob, is there any way I can see that card? Oh, by the way, it sounds like Sean Bratton wants Prism Football, so that's off the list. And that is Frank.
You're going to have to take this picture.
Okay.
I'm sorry, what did he take? I want to write that down.
Prism Football went to Sean Bratton. Sean, thank you for tuning in. I feel like this is the first time that I've seen you. Now, the Luck of the Lottery. So, wow. Yeah, Rob, this is Frank Ntilikina, right?
Mm-hmm.
Apparently,
close enough.
There's only 20, or no, it's not numbered to 25. Is it numbered to 25?
No, it's not numbered.
Because this says rookie card numbered to 25. It's got $46, 8 bids with 2 days left to go. Another
one
is listed at 66.
On. You know, sometimes the numbering's hard to see on Prism.
Well,
cards.
I think it could just be that it's like somebody calculated that.
I'm positive.
Because none of the others have a number on it, but this is really kind of crazy. I don't know what makes it different. Oh, it's a Mojo refractor. It is a Mojo refractor with a number. So this one's not the crazy big one. This one is more of like a $30, $25 card. Still very cool, though. Sorry.
Who was our last box winner so I could write that down, too?
S. Bratton, Prism Football.
No, I got Captain Coconut.
April Bendixson, Panini. I've got my.
Ivan, listen.
Yes.
Ivan.
Yes.
The one after Captain Coconut.
I haven't had a chance to say it yet.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. Who's that, then?
That's Adam. Beechin 11, at Beechin 11. New winner. I don't think I've seen him before. The name sounds a little familiar. Beechin 11. He might have won one time in the past on the show. So, Adam, thank you. Hope that you are watching. Let us know. Shoot us a DM on Twitter. First off, say hi in a chat room so we know you're here. And then shoot us a DM on Twitter of what you want. Minus Elite Extra Edition, Panini Chronicles, Gotham. Both boxes of Illusions are gone. Prism Football is gone. And I'm still trying to write Frank Ntilikina right here. Oh, gosh, the show is...
All right, while you do that, okay, I am going to bring the timer back to 6 minutes,
okay,
and you will understand why in just a minute. being that it is the holidays, I thought we would take a look at Santa Claus trading cards through the years. So I put a video together. Now, I had no idea when I started this project how many darn Santa Claus trading cards there are through the years. But there's a lot. But I put what I hope you'll find is an entertaining video together in two segments, the first of which we will play as soon as our executive producer, Joe Fallon, says it's time to do so, which is now. So enjoy this video, and we will be back with to pick another box winner as soon as this video is over.
GoGTS Live presents Santa Claus trading cards through the years. Cookies and milk, PB&J, bacon and eggs. Some things just go together, like Santa and trading cards. Some of Santa's first appearances on cardboard were in comic and pop culture properties like GPK and Marvel. But it was Pro Set in 1989 that first brought Santa Claus to sports cards. In 1991, Santa signed his first autographs. Pro Line had two different versions, one numbered to 2000 and an SP numbered to 200. Height of the junk wax era, Santa was everywhere. In 1993 and 1995, you were encouraged to have a Coke and a smile with Santa. The trend continued in 1994 1994, TCM produced a Santa Around the World trading card set consisting of 72 cards depicting what Santa Claus has been depicted as in countries through the years and around the world. The 72-card set featured puzzle packs that, once completed, depicted this holiday scene. Also randomly inserted were six foil parallels, which were pretty rare.
And that is a look at part one. You know what that sound means. It's time to give away another box.
I get no rest. I was so intrigued by that Santa video. I was like, okay, I'll, you know, and then it hits me. Just bang. So first off, I should let everyone know that Adam picked hoops basketball. He went for some hoops. Lots of fun. And this gentleman, the next winner, has a White Sox Avi, Gregory Frieders at Fried Sports. Avid White Sox, Bears, Bulls, and Blackhawks fan. Congratulations, Gregory. Gregory,
man,
message
after my
us.
Own heart.
Let us know you're here watching and what box you'd like from what remains, which is still quite a bit. Oh, my gosh. We're going to be here until Gazoot night.
All right. Well, guess what? In addition to the timer still rolling, it is time to dive back into a box break segment. This time we're going to look at some entertainment products.
So in honor of Santa Claus, we are going non-sports, even though there were some ridiculously awesome sports Santa Claus cards in there as well. I'm partial to the action-packed, though the Collector's Edge football with St. Nicholas the sleigh driver was awesome. That said, we're going bloody to start off with here, Rob. We are stepping up with evolution, first off, which means survival of the fittest. 2017 tops the Walking Dead Evolution trading cards. Ooh, are there going to be some bloody cards in there? I should have wrapped my little tops bat, or my, oh no, it's a PSA bat. I should have wrapped my PSA bat in some barbed wire. Walked around talking like Negan and having lots of fun.
Well, Rob, this chronicles Walking Dead through all seven seasons, I believe.
Spoiler alert! This box is going to deliver two hits.
Right away, Cesar Martinez, Jose Pablo Cantillo as Cesar Martinez on card autograph.
Wow. So that's one of our first
lucky
hits.
Winner.
That is our guaranteed autograph. Other hits include costume cards, sketch cards, character journeys, and every pack contains one parallel and one insert card. And you say I don't treat you good. What do you think? young Jeffrey Dean Morgan over here? Huh? Could I be in Watchmen? Can I be in Watchmen? Please, please, please. Oh, Rob, there's also sketch cards in this product, and each box is going to have 24 inserts, including adversaries, weapons, walkers, and no safe.
There's
haven.
Our second hit.
Ooh,
right off the bat.
Sasha
Williams.
Love that. Is that it? Is it a parallel? Look at the color on that, or the lack thereof.
Wow, it's an eBay 101 parallel. Good call. 10 of 10.
Ooh.
It's the black and white.
Sonequa Martin Green. And this is one of the fun things about non-sport trading cards is that she's now the star of Star Trek on CBS. Star Trek Discovery? Is that what it's called? Star Trek Evolution?
Star Trek.
Star Trek.
Star Trek. Trek.
So who knows where Saniqua Martin Green's career will take her, and yet you have a chance through this product to get her autograph. It's similar to Paul Rudd appearing in Parks and Rec.
All right. So this is kind of unusual. Ooh. Should I continue opening the packs, even though the two hits have been pulled, so we can at least look at some other inserts and parallels? How about I open packs until the timer goes off?
Okay. So you get to open some packs, and then the rest will stick
into prize packs. Yeah.
I have not seen anyone take playoff football. Is that what we're going with? Frieders. All right, Gregory, thank you for watching. Thank you for tuning in. You chose a box of playoff football. And was there only one box? I felt like there was two boxes of that anyways. Right? Was I crazy? All I got is this little image to go off of. I don't get the I get what you guys get. What I do with the collateral I'm given... You know, I make up hobby happenings on the spot every night.
Oh, my gosh.
I'm joking. Hobby happenings is created by the eloquent, the loquacious, the vivacious, the beautiful Rob Bertrand, who also writes the backs of certain trading card brands. So, yeah, full credit where full credit is due. That said, we're piecing together our own puzzle tonight with that list. So the playoff football goes to Gregory Frieders. Thank you for watching. Saniqua Martin Green needs to go on my giveaways list. Patch and Cesar Martinez.
Also, and we explained. People are like, "Well, we've been giving away the boxes. When do we give away the hit cards?"
Well, you gotta keep watching. That's how you got. That's how you're gonna win. So at the end, we'll give away the hit cards again. Though tonight, all you got to do is retweet the pinned tweet at GoGTS Live. It is pinned. It is live. You have to retweet that to enter because we draw our winners using tweet draw from that tweet. I just refreshed it and we've gotten. It's crazy. It just keeps going up the amount of people that have retweeted it. But you also have
to be. That's a great card. Watch. Adversaries, Nick. Are Rick and Megan. I like it. Good insert. I think what we'll do is the rest of those packs from this box.
Spoiler alert.
Would have been better if the Punisher had lived and Rick had died.
A lot of times the sketch cards are incremental hits in these boxes. So what we'll do is we'll stick some of the packs into our monthly prize packs.
Ooh!
No, I got it.
Ooh!
We did have the Santa sound. In case you missed it, it did go off. So it is time to give away another box.
But keep in mind, internal smartass comments that I'm editing myself, Rob. How impressive is that? Hey! Here's a winner from way back. He's been watching the show faithfully for a long time. He had a big win, I think, back at the very beginning of the year, but we haven't really seen much of him since on the winner's circle. So I
hope you say Seth Ward.
Oh, I'm sorry, Rob, and I'm sorry, Seth Ward. No, Jim Naylor. Jim Naylor, our veteran friend from Arizona, baseball card collector, U.S. Navy veteran. Congratulations, Jim. Thank you. You retweet us often, and you share. So I am happy to see you here. That said, Seth, don't go anywhere. We've got a lot of stuff to give away.
Look at this unique packaging for Alien. Can you see that?
Ooh, you're getting ahead of me, Rob, which is good because we do need to get going with that as well because this box has 18 packs. Each pack only has 5 cards.
It's going to open like an egg.
Oh, that's awesome. Pull it back just a little. Yeah, there you go. A little further more. Further back.
I can't
away from
without
me.
Disastering everything.
Yeah, you better have your face covered while you open this, you know. I've seen 7 of these movies. Can I tell a little story, Rob? Complete distraction. So I tweeted earlier this week. I should share it as my tweet of the week, actually. So my office mate is a 23-year-old, very bright guy. He's not your typical millennial. Well, he tells me that he's a film buff or that he's the movie buff of his friends. So this summer, we skip work one day because that's what true office mates do, right? And we go see Alien Covenant. It was a good movie. I was surprised. It was much better than Prometheus. as we're walking to the car, he's like, man, that was a great movie. And that's a great first card, by the way. That's awesome.
Yes.
Sorry, I'm watching on the Facebook, so I'm like 9 seconds behind, but awesome first card. So he says, that was a great movie, man. That was so much fun. He was all hyped about it and all this stuff. And he says, now help me understand, which one came first? Was it Prometheus or was it Aliens versus Predator? Which one was the first one? And I said, oh my God. You're fast becoming my best friend because of our work proximity relationship, and you don't know that the movie Alien was the first one? So, anyways, just yesterday for Christmas, I got him the Alien quadrilogy on Blu-ray so that he can begin his true film education. Because
good for you.
So,
what a good guy.
So the sad thing is, like, in talking with his friends now, because I've met some of his friends, I also like that airlock card on the inside the Nostrum.
Right.
He actually is relatively the film buff with the way that kids are today. Like, all his friends know, like, YouTube and Snapchat stars, and he actually does know.
No, I accidentally bumped the thingamajiggy.
Okay. Breaking news. Jim Naylor clearing out the hoops. He's grabbing the second box of Hoops Basketball.
Coolant.
Awesome. We know that he's a fan. Hopefully he'll get some good Phoenix Suns cards in that box. Jim, thank you. Happy holidays. Merry Christmas. Are we allowed to say that? I think our president said we could. We are proud to have you as a friend and a fan. So, Rob, the hits in this. There's going to be one manufactured patch and then one autograph, sketch, mineral ore, robot parts, or alien egg shadow box card in every box. And if you're curious what all that means, well, if you're on Facebook or live stream, I'm going to share the link to GoGTS.net where you can look at the cards from the sell sheet. Some very, very cool, very cool cards. Like, I'd be watching, even if I miss a box, the hits from this would be absolutely awesome. Or a hit.
And we have a box of this to give away.
Yeah, that's true. That is. We have a box of this, and we're opening this. Oh, I can't keep track of any of it. Ridiculously cool sketch cards, Nostromo materials. I'm actually not seeing an alien egg shadow box card on the thing. But the reason that I shared that link is not only so that you can get a little preview of what the cards look like. Guess what else? We have the checklist. If you want to know whose autographs are in this, if you want to know what inserts are in this, you can click on either a PDF or an Excel downloadable checklist. So we're doing the hard work for you.
How cool is that?
I think that's pretty cool. Oh, were you talking about a card?
No.
Oh, you were talking about the checklist. You know, I make up those checklists on the spot, Rob.
Look at that. That's a great card right there.
Bilbo Baggins.
A lot of cool inserts in this. Nice job, Upper Deck.
Yes, very cool. This is the set we needed.
No, whose birthday is it today? Happy birthday to Charlie McAvoy. Oh, you know what that sound means? Here, I think I missed it.
All right, my bad.
I heard a producer.
I heard a producer talking. Always sounds like he always sounds like Santa Claus. So
there we go. There it is.
All right.
Time to give away another box.
Well, I got to refresh. Well, I got to refresh the tweet first
to make sure that the people that doubt the way that everything works
get their due.
Skeptics out there. I tell you.
All that sarcasm. Keep it up.
All right. That's an interesting name.
That's an interesting name.
Oh, I know who that is.
He changed his name to Cancer Warrior. Stay positive and love your family no matter what. From Terrebonne, Oregon. Big Bear Bechtel.
Bechtel, congratulations.
Thank you.
You've been watching for a while,
but I don't know if you have one.
Well, thank you.
Happy birthday. And I don't know if you're advocating on behalf of cancer, if you're currently fighting yourself or someone you love. But that is something.
I think it might actually be Lance.
Lance Bechtel's fight against Hodgkin's lymphoma.
So if all of y'all go on Twitter,
just check this out. Well, I don't know. It's not vetted.
I shouldn't say anything.
But check out Lance's webpage, Big Bear Bechtel on Twitter.
And decide for yourself.
What's important in life.
semiotic patch. Manufactured, non-pressurized area beyond.
What?
Go ahead and give that away.
I got it.
All right.
All right.
Semiotic patch hit. So that's not a relic though. That's a manufactured patch, right? So we're still
correct.
We're still awaiting our relic.
Or auto, right?
Well, I don't know. It says one manufactured patch. So I'm getting
boom. This. How about a dual auto?
Oh.
This one of Tom Skerritt
yes.
as Dallas and Veronica Cartwright as Lambert. Sweet.
What an awesome pairing. Stasis signatures, because they were in stasis together. Are either of them on Twitter? Because that would absolutely make my day. Tom Skerritt. Nope. Oh, I know. That's why it would make my day, because they are old. It's always really fun when you see old people on Twitter.
They are old.
Which, spoiler alert, Weapons Luke Skywalker is on Twitter.
He's active on Twitter, too.
Oh boy. I'm getting emoji hate over here on Facebook. Sorry. Sorry, guys. Didn't mean to spoil it for you. Be warned. He's a real human being.
One's an insert with the same image on the base card. It's interesting. Paranoid Android. I want to go see the first movie. I mean, not go see. But
you should call my friend Russ. He just got the Quadrilogy on Bluetooth. You should go over and watch it with him. And then watch Porky's with him. That was the movie I wanted to get him that I didn't. I just ran out of options, but
another paranoid android.
So Lance, did we hear anything from Lance, by the way? I'm not seeing any new Facebook comments. Is that on me though? It probably is. My Facebook feed probably froze again. Yeah, Lance
Cancer
Bechtel.
Warrior. In space.
So my Facebook comments weren't.
No one can hear you scream.
Great tagline. Great.
Card number 100 to the base set.
I see Lance. He did say Panini Prism Football. Did we still have a Prism left? Okay, so Lance, we see that you're here.
We have Prism Football.
No. Shane Bratton.
You said playoff football.
No, Shane Bratton took Prism. Gregory Frieders took playoff. So sorry, this is going to happen possibly quite a bit right now. But Lance, Prism is taken already. Let me run through it real quick again. Elite Extra Edition's been taken. Panini Chronicles have been taken. Gotham's been taken. Both Illusions boxes. Prism Football. Two Hoops Basketball boxes. And Playoff Football have been taken. And I need to write down the Tom Skerritt and Elizabeth Otto.
Last two packs.
I'll tell you what I would take. I would take this alien stuff. This is awesome.
Deleted scenes.
So yeah, sorry about that, Lance, but you are still... Thank you for playing along. Thank you for adjusting with us. Thank you for tweeting Brugiers and telling them to send me some more, because this stuff is like $9 a bottle. It's ridiculous. And then they charge you $1.50 for the bottle, and you got to bring it back in order to get the... There isn't nutritional info. They're too smart.
It does look like straight cream.
Yeah.
All right, that wraps up Alien.
Montebello,
so we have
California.
A box of that available.
Oh, here you go. Who wants to do this for me? For nutritional info, call 323-726-0524. Who wants to get us the nutritional info on Brugiers while we transition into... Rob, is this what you're buying a box break of?
No.
Because, by the way, those comments,
by the
are,
way,
so
those comments
right
are so far gone right now, there's no way we're going to be able to pick them up.
But you know what that sound means?
Oh, that sound means that we're not going to transition into a new box break. We're just going to give away a new box. Oh, and DC Lance got in just in time.
Off the board.
He said hi earlier, so we weren't going to take it away from him. But he put in DC Bombshells is what he took. And this is also a new name, Cali Cubs Cheesehead. Cali Cubs Cheesehead. Well, hey, Cali Cubs Cheesehead, that's actually at T Byfield. I'll put that in the chat for our asset. T Byfield.
I have to say, I am a little surprised that we got Masterwork from Topps. And so thank you, Topps. We have
this is
four mini boxes.
Incredible product.
180, one hit per mini box.
180 MSRP. Rob, do you know what those hits are, possibly?
Tell me.
They are spread out between some amazing sketch cards, relics, medallions, or autographs, as well as one base parallel and three premium base cards in every mini box. And there's going to be two autographed cards guaranteed per master box. So there's four hits. Two of those will be autos. And then the other ones could be sketch cards, relics, or medallions. High-end set collectors have come to know and love this set. And it returns with new characters and new hits, as well as new autograph signers and wood, foil, and metal insert cards. Rob, I may actually stop talking and just watch this one.
Yeah.
Now, but you need to tell us what is it that you're breaking? Is it this? This is Marlin guessed this, and I pull. Ooh, that is thick. Ooh.
No, I'm not breaking this. My spots that I have. Mm-hmm. No, this is not it.
Is it Bowman Draft?
No, Star Wars Masterwork Parallel Base Parallel Number 2. Pretty sure it's 99. And our hit, an original animation cell. Wow.
Ooh.
That's really cool.
Yeah. Now that's really the question. Cool.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. I guess it wouldn't be.
I don't know who this is. Let's see.
I think James, the asset, was asking.
Wait a minute. You know, Tops, you might want to make this wording on there a little bit bigger. This is a one of one.
What? Well, yeah, if it's an original animation cell, it has to be a one. Like, that's a one-of-a-kind piece, right?
Wow.
Now, so the asset is asking me a question that many of you probably have, which is it canon? As in, does it count?
You have received an animation cell used in the televised series Star Wars Animated Adventures Ewoks.
Awesome.
That's really cool.
You got a picture of that to tweet, right? Do we know which Ewok
that
is? Okay. Does it say which Ewok it is, Rob?
It didn't say which Ewok it was. Mm-hmm. It didn't look like Wicket, though.
All right. Star Wars Ewok Animated Adventures. Oh, let's see if we can identify this. Ewok. Yeah.
Grand Wikipedia. Inquisitor.
No, I'm just Google image searching to see if it is like one of the main ones. It doesn't look like it's even maybe it is one of the main ones.
How about a blue parallel unnumbered of Lando Calrissian?
Ooh, very cool.
And our hit out of here is Garrick Hagen as Biggs Darklighter. Nice. And look at that auto.
Let's see it. Oh, yeah.
Fantastic.
Biggs auto. Very fun. So did Cali Cubs Cheesehead, I was going to say DM us on Twitter. Which box you would like?
Uh, All right, let's do this. Let's put a pause on the timer.
Oh, thank
you. Let me weed out the boxes that have been taken. So we still have Team Canada.
No one's taking Team Canada.
We still have Aliens. We still have Upper Deck Series Alien. 1. Alien, my bad.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah. Yeah, be careful about that, Rob. You're worse than Russ.
Let's see. Get rid of those. We have MVP Hockey.
Yep, MVP Hockey.
We have Outlander.
Outlander from Cryptozoic. Season 1 or Season 2?
Season 2.
Ooh.
Flash Season 2.
The Flash Season 2.
Don Ross Basketball.
Grant Gustin Auto in there, maybe.
Arrow Season 4.
Oh.
Two boxes of Ascension Basketball, now down to one. That's what Cali Cubs Cheesehead wants.
Okay, so Cali Cubs Cheesehead, thank you for watching. Thank you for, I believe it's your first time winning.
One box of that left. We have two boxes of Absolute Racing left.
And I think that we need to give a little shout out to Tyler Murphy, Team Earth Cards on Twitter. He actually just tweeted 6 minutes ago, so I should have seen this earlier. Sorry, I was too busy reading chat fun. He actually has a little crossed off list that he's made that he tweeted us.
Nice.
So that's pretty cool. Now we just got to cross off Panini Ascension. So we still got two Absolute Racing as well.
Two Absolute Racing, Ascension, Arrow, Don Ross Basketball, Flash, Outlander, MVP, Series 1, Alien, and Team Canada.
And look, guys, and gals, sorry. I use that term all-inclusively because I'm from Nebraska. It's no excuse. You're all on social media, clearly, because that's how you're engaging. So do us just one favor. When you get your boxes, tweet the hits, tag us, tag the manufacturers, thank the manufacturers, because at the end of the day, they do enable us to have this. This is stuff that they've given us to give to you in most cases. So tweet them and thank them. Tell them thank you. Show us what you hit, because we're not opening this. We're letting you have the fun of opening it. So just do us that little thing. Or on Instagram, GTS Sports Entertainment. You can follow us there. You can even get a shout-out there, possibly, if you post. So that's all I got. So thank you very much, Cali Cubs Cheesehead, for watching and choosing. All winners, email us. Email us at gogtslive@gogts.net. The name of the show.
Purple parallel numbered to 50.
At the name of the website. With your mailing
Boom!
Address.
How about a 101 printing plate auto?
What? Wow.
Tamo Morrison as Jango Fett.
Jango Fett, 101.
Fett, 101.
Yeah.
Wow.
No. Remember Jango Fett?
Santa.
Oh, I think Santa just came up to see Jango Fett. He said, I thought that guy lost his head. So the Jango Fett 1-of-1 autograph. And Santa's here, which means we got to give away another box.
We're running out of time.
That was pretty good.
All right. Hey, Jackie Bridgman. Hello, Jackie.
Last mini box.
Welcome. Congratulations on your first time showing up on the show. You have 6 minutes to let us know.
We hope all you new viewers come back and join us every week.
What box you want?
We love giving stuff away. Yeah, there's one in every, and this is the last one. It's so far, not a dud in the box.
Jackie Bridgman.
Even the base cards are cool. And Forrest Whitaker. Blue, unnumbered parallel. And Sharon Duncan Brewster as Senator Pomlo, numbered to 25 auto.
So we did. We pulled three autos from this box that guarantees two autos. Three of our four hits were autos. That's pretty awesome.
We got, including a 101 printing plate, and our other hit was a 101 animation cell.
what was her name again?
Nice
I didn't write that down because I was Too busy laughing at my own jokes.
Sharon Duncan Brewster.
Sharon Duncan Brewster. Did you notice that, James?
All right.
It was not on you. That's why I mentioned that.